mai devreme din rai. There are many things to consider in today's gospel. Let us focus on several of the most important issues. First of all, we wonder in what way was Jesus tempted. How, furthermore, did Jesus respond to the temptation? Finally, what do his answers to the devil suggest about Jesus' character? What do they tell us about Jesus himself? Later on, we can make a few applications for our daily life during this 14-day season of Lent. In the first temptation, the devil said, "Turn this stone into bread." The devil is very clever. He knows that Jesus is very hungry. After his long fast, and so he appeals to Jesus' senses. Now, as we might suspect, the temptation is not merely to eat something. The devil here is tempting Jesus' human nature. All the physical cravings and desires of the body. The temptation is to live an easy life, to avoid discipline and hard work. I still remember when I was small, when my father put me in the Catholic school, he told me, "I want you to be disciplined." Some people say that our life is to eat, to drink, and be merry. Enjoy all the comfort life provides. But Jesus refuses. Man does not live by bread alone, but as in Matthew has in his account, by every word that comes from the mouth of God. In other words, my dear friend, Jesus said that the center of our life is not our belly. The center of our life is not our stomach. The center of our life is the heart. The heart needs food as well. That's why we are longing for the word of Jesus. We are longing for the Eucharist, because Jesus is the bread of life. To feed us, to feed our soul, to feed our heart, so that we are able to share that love to others. By controlling our bodily desires, we are able to direct them to higher senses. We are even able to purify them, as it were, and to make the body serve the spirit. Ultimately, we are able even to offer our body to God as a pleasing gift to Him. Some people say, "Why are you so handsome? You want to become rich? So wait. Why you are so pretty, so beautiful, you want to become a nun or to give your life for Jesus?" My dear friend, we are not the owner of our body. Our body belongs to God. Then we must take care not to abuse it for our own pleasure. In the second temptation, the devil takes Jesus to a higher place. These suggest that the temptation is more appealing and harder to overcome than the first one. Then from this high place, the devil told Jesus in a moment of time all the kingdom of the world. I will give you all this power and glory. Worship me and with something of yours. We can imagine, my dear friends, how appealing such a temptation has once been to Jesus. As a Jew, surely he would prefer to have Israel govern itself, rather than living as a colony of Rome and subject to Roman taxes and other restrictions. And how easy it would be to master all the people to his side. He could show strong leadership and form them into a powerful force, maybe even an army. Jerusalem would be the capital and he would reign as a king there. Then he could go through all the known parts of the world, conquering everyone. He could even do it for a good purpose, to establish justice, to be a hero. What a temptation, how appealing. But again, Jesus raised his head, you serve you holy to the Lord your God. He alone self you adore. In other words, my dear friend, Jesus was saying, I do not need to be honored, then that is for God. My task is simply to obey and to carry out his will. That is enough. How many times, my dear friends, in our life, we face the same temptation. Leave your Catholic faith. I will give you promotion. I will make you the president of this company. But leave your faith in me. The third temptation is also very appealing. Throw yourself down from the temple. You will not be served, for you are God's favorite one. And in doing this, everyone will know for sure that you are the chosen one, the Messiah. This temptation is very subtle. It is an appeal to fame. Let everyone see your miraculous power. Let them praise you, let them make you a king. Become popular, become famous. But Jesus replied, you shall not put the Lord your God to test. First of all, it would not be right to presume that God would save me from harm. I will not test God by doing something. And secondly, I have not come to win fame. I do not want to be a king, at least not an earthly queen. I have come to serve and obey. My dear friends, how many times in our lives we try to put God into test as well. Many times I heard parishioners complain, Father, I pray so much, but I feel empty. I feel dry. I don't want to pray anymore. I come to church, but God never gives me a sign that He is present, that He is active. God, if you give me that I strike my total 1 million, then I will give the campaign for the poor. We put God into faith. That's why it never happened. My dear friends, let us think about one more point.